Hello friends, welcome to History and Mythology. Today we are going to discuss a phenomena called Did humans ever live on any of the Earth pole? Miles of thick ice, stronger wind, and darkness of 6 months make this place non-habitable. Then how can we even think and say that poles were habitable once? If you are new to our channel, then please consider subscribing to our channel. With your support, my channel can grow and survive. Recently, research team of Russia has studied the Zhokhov site, which is located in the high-latitude Arctic. Researchers discovered the remains of an ancient people here. The Zhokhov site considered the earliest evidence for human habitation in the high Arctic. Researchers believe 25 to 50 people permanently resided in the area around 9300 to 8600 years ago. In the remote past, Zhokhov Island was a part of the vast plain formed due to drastic sea level drop during the last glacial maximum. Because of the post-glacial sea level rise, this plain was flooded and eroded. At present, the Zhokhov site located in the southwestern part of the modern Zhokhov Island, near the foot of a 120-meter hill, which sealed it from the severe northwest wind. This place was very convenient for ancient people. The hill served as an observation point, and because of the proximity to the coast, they always had a supply of driftwood carried in by the tide. But now, here is the biggest question: how these ancient people could live in so opposite environment? Or in the ancient time, the temperature was much moderate and milder in this area? Let's try to investigate it. How can any place become favorable for life? The first and foremost condition is the climate in terms of temperature. If the temperature of any place remains mild and moderate, then it helps in mobilizing the element that meet the needs of life. If somehow we can prove that in the ancient time, climate was suitable for life in the Arctic region, we might be able to solve the mystery. In the past, there were some certain astronomical conditions that occurred in space, which made this place climate much milder and moderate than today. At an obliquity of 0 degrees, the two axis point in the same direction, the rotational axis is perpendicular to the orbital plane. Earth obliquity oscillates between 22.1 and 24.5 degrees on a 41,000 year cycle. Earth mean obliquity is currently 23 degree 26 minute and decreasing. Decreasing means more chances for the ice age. When obliquity is maximum, then poles is exposed maximum to the sun, that means high temperature on poles. Earth own axial precession. Earth rotates once a day around its rotational axis. This axis itself rotates slowly, completing a rotation in approximately 25,772 years. If we look into this picture, then we can see that in 10,000 AD, Earth poles will be maximum exposed to the sun. So approximately 12,000 to 30,000 BC, Earth was in the same condition where poles were maximum exposed to the sun. Earth eccentricity. the Earth's rotation around its axis and revolution around the Sun evolve over time due to gravitational interaction with other bodies in the solar system. Eccentricity is simply the shape of the Earth's orbit around the Sun. This constantly fluctuating orbital shape ranges between more and less elliptical on a cycle of about 100,000 years. These oscillations from more elliptic to less elliptic are of prime importance to glaciation in that it alters the distance from the Earth to the Sun. When the Earth's orbit is most elliptical, the amount of solar energy received at a perihelion would be in the range of 20 to 30% more than at aphelion. At present, the orbital eccentricity is nearly at the minimum of its cycle. What this above astronomical and gravitational phenomena explains. In the past, exposure of the poles towards Sun was maximum by having maximum tilt angle and maximum precession. Earth had the shortest orbit where the Earth received maximum radiation from the Sun, which helps the Earth temperature to become mild and moderate and more favorable for habitation. This image explained the temperature rising at poles in the past. When the temperature rises, the thickness of the ice reduced, and that happens in a very short span of time. So approximately 8000 BC, temperature came to its maximum position, which is the same as of today. These long glacial periods were separated by more temperate and shorter interglacials. If you like this video, then please consider subscribing to our channel and share this knowledge with your family and friends.